Welcome to our best messenger bag review. We are going to cover our picks for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 best messenger, come here, best messenger bags that money can buy. We don't like to pick an actual best anything on this channel. Instead, we split our 5 favorite messengers into 5 distinct categories and user cases so you can figure out which messenger is best for you and your specific needs. And each messenger in this review has its own independent review that you can find in the description below. And for those of you who don't know, I'm Aaron, he's Tab, we're Nomads Nation, we do the best travel gear reviews on the web. If you dig travel gear, hit that subscription button, click the notification bell. Let's talk about some messenger bags. Real quick, before we jump into the actual list, let's just make sure we're all on the same page here for what a messenger is. In essence, a messenger is a bag that has to be worn over the shoulder or cross body. It has a single strap, and usually they're on the smaller size. They're not for like long-term travel. It's more of an everyday carry. So the first messenger on our list is the Peak Design Everyday Messenger, and it's our pick for the best messenger bag for photographers. Like all Peak Design gear, this is definitely catered to photographers, but the beauty of it is that anybody can get use out of it, because even if you're a photographer, you're not doing photographer things every second of every day. So it can carry your photography gear, it can carry your regular gear, it's just sort of an all-arounder. There is a lot to love with this messenger. Peak Design utilizes really high quality materials, whether it's this magnetic mag latch right here, waterproof zippers that are PU coated and custom made. Peak Design makes their own zippers, how cool is that? And then also, this guy's gonna come with Peak Design's signature flex fold dividers. As the name infers, these are flexible and they fold and they help you to create customized division and organization in your messenger. This is particularly helpful if you are a photographer, because you can create specific nooks and crannies for your lenses, your bodies, and there's also specific pockets for your gear, such as SD cards, batteries, things of that nature. Some specs of the Peak Design Everyday Messenger bag. It comes in 13 liters. You got 2 color options. It comes in black or gray. Personally, I like the gray much more. It weighs 2.2 pounds, which is fairly lightweight compared to some of the other messengers we'll look at. And it costs around $220 US. Now, let's talk about some overall pros and some cons with this messenger bag. Pro number one is going to be the comfort. It's really comfortable. This comes down to 2 things: a very well padded strap, a little bit of denseness to it, but it's comfy. And then you also have this swivel system that I previously mentioned, which greatly helps with the comfort. Why, you might ask? Because the messenger moves with your body. As you're moving it around from front to back, over the shoulder, whatever position that you're in, this swivel system makes sure that the messenger bag moves with you. Pro number two is going to be the next level materials. Now at $220, it better have awesome materials. But this guy really nails it. Obviously the swivel system, but then we have things like the magnetic latch right here, which is functional and satisfying to use. The external material is quite nice too. It's a 400D double poly coated DWR impregnated nylon canvas shell. Say that 10 times fast. Which means that this material is durable and highly waterproof. The bottom is 900D, so super, super, super durable and protected against rain. And pro number three is that I really fell in love with these side pockets. You've got one on each side. They're really just awesome for functionality. It's one simple step to grab whatever's in there, whether it's your phone, your keys, your wallet. These pockets are awesome. But there's some cons. We're gonna talk about them. Con number one is that I don't think it's the sexiest looking messenger in the world. It's a little blobby to me. Tab thinks it looks like a frog. Call you Kermit. Con number two is that I wish that it didn't automatically come with the flex fold dividers. There's no option not to have these, and these are really well engineered and made from great materials, which means that they're not cheap, which means that they're jacking up the price of this thing because of it. And I wish that there was an option to say, no flex fold dividers for me, please. If you are interested in learning more about the Peak Design Everyday Messenger bag, check the description below. We have a link to the full review. It's a big review. It's an epic review. Check it out. It's huge. It's the best review ever.
Is that the best?
Okay, the second messenger on our list is the Nomatic Messenger Bag, and it's our pick for the best messenger bag for business professionals. Nomatic is known for making really sexy gear that's also highly functional. You've got that real sleek, businessy look to it, really nice profile, and a ton of Nomatic's like just really cool, fun to use features. Whether it's the magnetic clip for the straps, ooh, that's fun. Or Nomadic's very well thought out internal organization. So if you're a business professional and you got a laptop, you got a Bluetooth keyboard, you got a Bluetooth mouse, whatever it might be, this is designed to carry all of your gear. You got the laptop compartment in the back and more storage in the front. And one interesting note is that this panel is actually completely removable. And you can switch it out with another panel that I don't have with me right now because I like this panel much more, but you can do that. But really, I emphasize on organization and pockets. Nomadic loves their pockets. I mean, look how many pockets this entire section has. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 pockets. 10 if you count this guy, I count this guy. It's 10 pockets just here. So business traveler, lots of little tidbits you're taking with you, need a spot for everything. Let's talk about some specs of the Nomadic Messenger. Its capacity is 15 liters. It only comes in one color option, the black you see before your eyes right now. The weight is gonna clock in just under 4 pounds. It's 3.8 pounds, which is heavy. We'll talk about that in the cons section in just a sec. And the price is gonna be around 230 USD. Let's talk about some of the pros and the cons. Pro number one is that I think that this dude looks so sleek. Like, it's a messenger that says something. This tarpaulin material has a really nice look to it. It's shiny, it's almost leathery, and it's also quite water resistant. So the look is just, Pro number two is gonna be the internal organization. Enough said. And pro number three is gonna be easy transition from messenger to just brief mode. Look how easy that was. Pop these guys off, and now kaboom, I got a briefcase. But we got some cons to talk about. Con number one. And this is a big one. I don't think it's very comfortable. I'm not saying it's like painful, but it can be uncomfortable. This is attributed to a few things. One, it's heavy. But two, it's really gonna come down to the actual shape. It's just kind of boxy, it bounces around, it doesn't really like fit on the body as comfortably as some other messengers. I will say the shoulder strap is comfortable, it's really well padded, but really it's just that the shape is, you're gonna have a little problem with it sometimes, at least I did. And the second con is going to be, while this external material, tarpaulin, is great for water resistance, it's terrible for scratch resistance. So if you graze this against the corner of like a table, it might slash it, and that slash could be permanent. And if you're looking for a really sexy professional looking sort of messenger, a big old slash in the messenger might not be ideal. In essence, keep this messenger away from your ninja swords. If you are interested in learning more about this sexy business professional messenger, take a look at the description. We have a link to our full review. Okay, our number three messenger on the list is our pick for best leather messenger, because that's definitely a thing. It's the Kodiak Buffalo Leather Satchel. Now listen, buffalo leather is not going to be for everyone. So if you're like, dude, I ain't the buffalo leather, I get it, move past. But some people, they're going to see this and be like, oh my God, that's me. An old 1800s cowboy, like that's like my spirit animal. This is the type of messenger that really says something about you. It's not subtle. People are gonna notice, because they're gonna be like, that's a lot of leather going on. And in a lot of ways, I think that the look is quite versatile. If you're the creative type or the artsy type, wouldn't look strange, and it could even work in a business environment as well. But really, when it comes to these materials, the leather in particular, it's 100% top grain water buffalo leather. It looks like something that maybe your grandfather would have passed down to you, but this guy's going to outlive like your grandkids. And it should be noted that this is a very minimalist type messenger. There's not a lot of internal organization going on. A couple of compartments, and then this front pocket here, and that's kind of it. So if you're in the market for a minimalist leather messenger, this is kind of a match made in heaven for you. Let's talk about some of the specs of this leather satchel. There's actually three different color options available. This is the antique brown, but there's also a dark walnut. Ooh. And a darker walnut. It's actually just called black. They have a black one as well. I'm not sure what the liters is. It doesn't specify on the website. I'd say probably somewhere around 8 to 10 liters. It's definitely a lot smaller compared to like some of the other messengers. So this is 15 liters. So this is 8 to 10, I'd say. The weight isn't on the website. So let's see what it comes down to. Yes, we have a scale for measuring our bags. Weight, what are you? It's, wow, 4 pounds on the dot. Heavy. And the price is gonna run around 230 US dollars. Okay, let's talk about some pros and cons with this guy. Pro number one, the buffalo leather is just insane. Wow. Pro number two is gonna actually be this brass hardware. Now, I know it's not gonna be a look that everyone digs, but in terms of reliability, it's gonna be durable. And it does add like a cool aesthetic to the bag. And pro number three is that it's just really well made. It's handcrafted. The stitching is pretty incredible. This messenger is going to last the test of time. But I got a few cons too. Con number one, it's not very comfortable. You've got a leather strap. It's a part of the Buffalo leather lifestyle, but you know, leather isn't as comfortable as like EVA foam padding. It literally looks like a saddle, right? Con number two is going to be the scratchability of the Buffalo leather, or at least the finish. Like, see that? I just did that. Now, I think that this is a part of the Buffalo leather lifestyle. You know, you want it to get some wear and some tear and to show the marks of your journey, but some people will get turned off by this. And con number three is that it's minimalist, but it might be a little too minimalist for some. There's really not a lot going on. If you're looking for a little bit more organization, this might not be the messenger for you. To learn more about the Kodiak Buffalo leather satchel, check the description. There's a link there and it will take you to our full review.
See you, cowboy.
Okay, number four on the list is going to be our best messenger bag / brief bag hybrid, the Air Commuter Brief 2. Now, as to where other messengers do all have a top handle and you can carry it as a brief, truth be told, the ones that we reviewed are messengers first, brief second, but this one literally is kind of 50-50. You got these two amazing handles right here, which make for a very comfortable and functional brief carrying experience. But then you also got the shoulder strap that you can take into full messenger mode as well. Air is known for making high quality gear that's sexy and has a lot of features in terms of pockets and organization. As you can see right here, we've got like all these pockets, all of these compartments in sort of Air's branded style that they use across all of their packs. This is the area of the messenger where you would sort of organize your everyday essentials, just things that you want to grab fast. Gum, headphones, iPad, pen, notebook. And then you got a main compartment where you just sort of throw your bulkier items, laptop compartment, throw a jacket in there, water bottle right there, good to go. We've got two external materials that I want to chat about real fast. You've got Cordura Ballistic Nylon, which is this like rugged yet smooth to the touch material here. And then we've got an 840D nylon with a polyurethane coating right here, which has like more of a leathery, rubbery type feel. I love not just the functionality of these materials, but also how they look. They bounce and play off of each other very well and gives it a very professional, yet still like hipstery sort of aesthetic. Let's talk about some of the specs. Weight, 3 pounds. Volume, 13 liters. Color options, just one, just black. And the price is gonna come in at around $150. So we'll talk about some pros and some cons with this guy. Pro number one, the next level materials. Pro number two is gonna be the comfort. This thing is highly comfortable to wear. You've got a really well padded shoulder strap right here, and there's also a decent amount of ventilation. So messenger mode, quite comfy. But also brief mode, these two handles, it gives you a little bit of maneuverability. And the handles themselves are quite comfortable. And pro number three, I love Air's organization. Simple, yet effective. But cons. Con number one, you hear that? You see these Air zips? It's like Christmas, and not everyone likes that, what is sometimes referred to on the internet as the Air Jingle experience. Con number two, and this is a big one, muy importante, is that the shoulder strap is actually quite short. Now I'm 5'8", and I have loosened the shoulder strap as much as possible. And this is as low as it goes on me. And that's fine if you're going into this mode. But when you go cross body, it just rides up a little high. It's a little too tight. I just wish that Air gave us a little bit more room to play with. If you would like to learn more about the Air Commuter Brief 2, check the description. We've got a link to the full review down there. All right. Final messenger on our list is actually our pick for the best messenger / sling hybrid. Another Air product, the Air Tech Sling 2. I want to preface this by saying out of any product I've ever reviewed, we've done about 70 videos, I think, This one's my favorite. Number one, numero uno. Let me tell you why. First off, I will accept it's not a pure messenger, but it 100% can be worn as a messenger. Yet again, messenger, shoulder number one, shoulder number two, you're in messenger mode. But then you can put this guy over front, and this is like the main way it's supposed to be worn, is sort of like over the shoulder sling mode, like this. But then you can even do just like the one backpack type thing, because you got this shoulder padded strap right here, which I'll talk about in a second. And it's particularly awesome because, as the name would infer, it fits a decent amount of tech gear. It's tight, I'll explain that in detail in a second, but you got a padded laptop compartment and plenty of organization for your smaller tech gear. Yeah, it's actually just like a little brother to the brief, isn't it? Big bro, little bro. Let's talk about some of the specs of this guy. You get one color option, black. The capacity is 8 liters. It weighs 1.4 pounds and it runs around $90. The most important spec to keep into consideration is the capacity. 8 liters for a messenger is a little on the smaller side. Like you said, you do have the laptop compartment and it can fit an impressive amount of stuff, but obviously not as much as the larger messengers that we reviewed. Hence why this is really a messenger slash sling. Big sling, little messenger, kind of combined into one. Now let's talk about some pros and some cons. Pro number one, love me the organization. Pro number two is that it's a sling that can carry a laptop, which is kind of a rarity. And pro number three is going to be the amazing comfort and versatility of how it can be worn. Whether you're doing the half pack, the messenger, as we call it, the Legolas, the AirTech Sling 2, it's got you covered. But as much as I'm in love with this guy, I got some cons. Con number one is you get a little bit of that air jingle zipper experience, which really irks some people. And con number two is that while the zippers are high quality, YKK, none of them are waterproof. And I would have liked at least the laptop compartment to have been a waterproof PU coated zipper. If you are interested in learning more about my love affair with the AirTech Sling 2, you know what to do. Description, link, click it, watch it. If you're still here, it probably means you're not sure which of the five messengers is best for you. If that's the case, I recommend just checking out the reviews one by one. Our reviews are thorough, and the good news is that they're split into different sections, so you can jump to the part that you're most interested in. Aside from that, what do you think of our list? Did we miss any great messenger bags? If so, let us know in the comments below. It not only helps our community get more educated, but it just helps the internet run as a whole. Also, subscribe. Please, please subscribe. And hit the like button. Please, hit the like button. Thanks so much, guys, and we'll see you next time.